Hello, welcome to my channel. Today in material handling we are going to discuss all about pneumatic conveyors. Now in our previous video we have already discussed on belt conveyor, chain conveyor, cable and haulage conveyor, roller conveyor, then screw conveyor. Then we have also discussed about hydraulic conveyors, and we already know about how these type of conveyors are working, what are the basic things need for this conveying system, all of this conveying system, and what are the design aspects of all of the conveying system. What we have already studied earlier, or I have already mentioned earlier, we have known all of these things. If you miss any of this video, you can go to my YouTube channel. You can find each and every topic on conveying system and different type of conveyors. Okay, so now we will move on to the pneumatic conveyor. So in case of pneumatic conveyor is nothing but it is a basic process of conveying where granular or powdered material are conveyed by floating the materials in a gas, basically air, then allowing it to flow to the destination through a closed pipe. Okay, now pneumatic conveyor are a continuous conveyor for moving the bulk material, in which the material is conveyed in an enclosed tube system. Okay, now sometimes compressed air is used, or sometimes vacuum is used for conveying this type of material in case of a pneumatic conveying system. This type of conveyor is extremely flexible in terms of routing. Both compressed air and vacuum system are based on the same principle, according to which solid particles, when the air velocity is fast enough, are picked up by the conveyor airflow and conveyed along the pipes. Okay. Now there are some certain advantages of these advantage as well as disadvantage of a pneumatic conveying system. Okay, now pneumatic conveying system is used for delivering non-sticky dry material via pipelines through to various storages or process points, which are economically inaccessible by the conventional conveyors. Okay, conventional conveyors mean the belt conveyor or chain conveyor. Now the major advantage for using this type of pneumatic conveying system, we can say that materials can be picked from one or more point, and it can be delivered to one or more point in a plant or even outside to a different plant. Okay, then we can say that the conveying of materials take place through airtight piping, since that's why auxiliary system and auxiliary system is attached to this type of tight piping system. Okay, that's why neither this system doesn't pollute the environment, or the material is not getting contaminated with foreign materials. Okay, so it is a very safe operation. It also offers plant and operator safety, since in case of handling the fine powder material which may be toxic for nature or which may be fire prone. Okay, as well as it is a very flexible system, the conveying pipe can be routed and rerouted with a little effort as per demand of the operations, whatever required. Then it is very simple that it can be possible to unloading the material from sea barge transport vessel directly to the storage bin, and it is a very important part and very important point which is most widely applicable in different kind of ports. Okay, and due to the pipeline system, it is also a self-cleaning system which actually prevents the accumulation of materials in the conveying system. Because of this, the same installation may be used for conveying different type of materials. Just you need to clean the system very easily. Okay, so that's why low maintenance cost is available for this type of system, and it also offers a low cost material handling system compared to handling storage of bulk material in bags or small containers. And another important thing you can say that this pneumatic conveyor system can be operated automatically, and it can be easily integrated into manufacturing process as feeders. Okay, now there are different advantages what we have already discussed. Now apart from that, there are some disadvantages what you must know. That is, the type of materials is suitable for pneumatic conveyor is limited to material which is dry, granulated, pulverized or crust. Which is actually free flowing. So if the material is moist or pulp
और
If the material there is some large lump, it can't be moved by using this type of pneumatic conveying system. Then too much abrasive material can be transported, since abrasiveness will delay the process of pneumatic conveying. Then movement of transportation is fixed, that means unidirectional, only one direction it can move at a time. Okay, then relatively high energy consumptions occurred, since there is an automated system and some more number of pumps are used for pneumatic conveying. And the length of pneumatic conveying is very limited. Vacuum systems are limited to 500 meter, where high pressure system can be limited up to 2 kilometers or marginally more. Whereas you can say the conventional material handling system, they comes to more and more long conveying system. Okay, now in case of different type of pneumatic conveyor, we can say there are basically three type of pneumatic conveyor what we will study. Number one is a pipeline conveyor. Another one is the air activated gravity conveyor, which is also known as air slide, and another is the tube conveyor. So first we need to study about the pipeline conveyor. Now this pipeline conveyor, they are actually made on the basis of air pressure used. Okay, so as per the design criteria for pneumatic conveying system, it can be classified into three different types. One is the low pressure system, in which the air pressure is normally limited to 1 atm, that 1 atm gauge, one gauge pressure, that means, and supplied by a positive displacement low pipe blower, which is actually known as the Roots blower. This system are restricted to a short distance, maximum up to 500 meter, and small flow rate. Okay, these systems are further sub-classified into three type of pressure system. Okay, depending on different pressuring system. One is the positive pressure system, another one is the negative pressure or suction system, another one is the combined negative pressure system. Now, apart from that, there are the medium pressure system, high pressure system, medium pressure system. So basically positive, negative and combined pressure, these are included into the low pressure system. In case of medium pressure system, the air pressure limits from 1 to 3 atm gauge atm. Okay, and in case of high pressure system, 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure, which is actually known as the grace pressure. Okay, and medium and high pressure system are actually positive pressure system type. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the positive pressure system. In case of a positive low pressure pipeline system, that is the one in which a positive airflow created by a positive displacement blower effectively transports slow flowing material over a distance up to 500 meter. If you see the figure on the right hand side, it is a typical positive pressure system. The basic principle of operation is nothing but a positive displacement blower, low type or root blower, sucks air from the atmosphere through a suction filter and delivers pressurized air into the conveyor pipeline. Materials to be conveyed are introduced into the pipeline from the feeding bin or hopper through different type of air locker feeder at control rate. Now this air locker feeder, they are used at the outlet port of the feeding silos for discharging of the materials into the pipeline without being blown out from the top. Such silos are, because of high air pressure, the material is so introduced and immediately air laden and blown to one number of receiving bins or silos through diverting valves, which is also known as changeover valve. Okay, now these diverting valves are generally designed for one inlet and two outlet, but multiple outlet are also possible. Now these valves operated either manually or through remote control actuator. Okay, the principal advantage of this system is that the blower does not handle dusty air. However, the major disadvantage of this system is the possible leakage happens of the high pressure air along with materials to the surroundings. Okay, so this is the positive pressure system, and now we will see the suction system or the negative pressure system. And basically in this type of system, a positive displacement blower creates a vacuum in the conveyor pipeline, which occurs the material to be sucked through one or multiple nozzle and conveyed to a receiving hopper. Okay, major advantage of system is that leakage point, air from the surrounding enters at the system, and hence air pollution through material leakage is virtually nil. Okay, so this is a major advantage. So in case of this type of suction system, if you see the figure, easy flowing materials like cereals, grains, powder materials are conveyed in the suction conveyor. In this system, materials from multiple storage points may be collected and transported to a single storage unit. The distance and the volume of the conveying is also limited because of the actual vacuum created inside the pipeline, and which is not below 0.3 atm pressure, okay, which is actually the absolute pressure. Then there comes the combined negative positive pressure system or combination system, where the principle of both positive and suction system are employed. Okay, this type of pneumatic conveyor is particularly employed when the materials from more than one point have to be picked up and simultaneously delivered to a multiple delivery point. For this system, generally one positive delivery blower is used. Two separate blower may be also used for the suction line and pressure line for the combustion system. Now, the suction side of the blower conveys the material from the storage point to an intermediate receiving station. The suction air also passes through this intermediate receiving station and then through a cyclone separator. And what cyclone separator you can see on this figure, which is marked over here, cyclone separator. Okay, and the compressed air is then thrown into the pressure delivery pipeline, into which the materials from the intermediate storage is discharged through necessary airlock feeder. Now, this type of system, they actually convey the multiple storage silo as per positive pressure system, what I have already said earlier. Okay, then we'll talk about the medium and high pressure system. Now, in case of medium and high pressure system, these systems are basically similar to a positive pressure system, and it also supports the same operational principle. Now, the difference is the range of air pressure is used. Because of the use of increasing air pressure, that means you know that 3 to 7 atm pressure, the medium and high pressure system principally differ from a low pressure system in two aspects. Now, number one, the air supply equipment will vary according to the pressure selected. Another one is the feeding device that is used to be different to make the system leak through. Now, a single stage rotary compressor is used for the medium pressure pneumatic conveying system, where double stage rotary compressor is used for the high pressure system. The medium pressure system is generally operate continuously, while the high pressure system may be used for continuous, basically used for batching operation. Okay. In case of a medium pressure system, a screw feeder, you can also say that that is a screw pump that is used for feeding materials from the feeding hopper or silo to the conveyor pipe. Now, these screw feeder are suitable for safe, that means no leakage of the air through hopper is happening. Now, for safe operations, okay, up to air pressure from 2.5 to 3 atm gauge, which is gauge pressure. And for high pressure system, the feeding material is done through a blow tank, which is also known as the chamber feeder type of line charger. Now, in case of medium and high pressure system, the material flow takes place in the dense phase. That means the mass flow ratio of the material particle to air is over 15. That means more than 15. And for the so dense phase means the mass flow ratio of the material particle is greater than 15. And for the low pressure system, that actually uses the mass flow ratio which is less than 15, and that is also known as dilute phase. Okay. Now, depending on different type of properties of material like bulk density, particle size, then material characteristics, different type of pneumatic handling system are being selected. And there is a certain chart given which is actually shows the material minimum air velocity depending on average bulk material, approximate size, and minimum air velocity. Okay. Now, the next point what we need to discuss, that is the air activated gravity conveyor, which is also known as air slide. Okay, you can see the figure which is given at the bottom side, and the different part of the air slide is mentioned over here. Now, dry powdered material, which actually acquires the fluidity, which can also move along a plane having a slight inclination, can be moved through this air activated gravity conveyor. This is nothing but one type of a trough conveyor, which has certain inclination angle. Okay, this principle is adopted in an air slide for the short distance movement of powder material in a fairly controlled rate. We also include the gravity principle of material handling in this type of air activated gravity conveyor, as you know that there is a certain slope of this type of air activated gravity conveyor with a 4% to 5% slope. Now this air slide consists of an inclined covered metallic trough with a longitudinal porous partition in between. Over the partition, the material actually moves, and low pressure air is allowed to enter from the bottom of the porous partition. The air fluidizes the powered or pulverized the material and make it flow along the inclined portion due to the gravity. Now these air slides are generally used for controlled movement of materials, that means the feeder. For their simple design, low cost, low power consumption, high handling capacity combined with small overall dimension, simple erection and adjustment, absence of moving and wearing parts, it is a very preferred type of feeders over the screw or vibrating feeders. Okay, materials such as cement, as coal dust, this type of materials which is very powderly and pulverized, it can be effectively conveyed by this type of air activated gravity conveyor. So it is widely used in different type of industry, mostly in the manufacturing industry, and manufacturing means the cement manufacturing industry, or in the power plants, okay, where you need to move the ash or coal dust from one portion of the power plant to the another portion of the power plant. The next conveyor, which is a very common and easy conveyor, that is the tube conveyor. Now small pipe, when the small pipe or small piece of goods in standardized containers, which is actually known as the carriers, are transported pneumatically over a short distance, that is actually known as the tube conveyor, because there a tube or pipe is being used for conveying this type of containers through a small distance. Okay, now this type of transportation of piece goods or unit loads are used in telegraph office, bank, stores, newspaper office, also in some kind of industries. Now this interaction between environment and conveyed material are very limited, and it can be eliminated by encapsulating the material while transportation. The speed of the carriers which moves through this tube conveyor, they are limited to a certain range of 6 to 12 mps. Okay, now the next thing what we need to know, there are different type of pipeline conveyor. So different parts of pipeline conveyor, or different parts or accessories makes up of different type of pipeline conveyor. They are suction nozzle, feeding or intake unit for introduction of material into pipeline, changeover or diverting valves, separator and dust collector. Okay, now first of all you need to know the suction nozzle, which are generally used for sucking material into the pipe of suctional conveyors. It is basically a piece of pipe connected with the main conveying pipe through flexible hose. Okay, part length of this pipe is jacketed by another concentric tubular piece. The jacket is closed at the bottom with a inner pipe where it is open at the top. Number of holes are created at the bottom side of the inner pipe. When the assembly is dropped into the material, part of the nozzle end get burst into the heap of the material. And when the suction blower is switched on, the air enters between the jacket and the inner pipe through opening at the top and passes through the holes at the bottom part and the inner pipe. Okay, through the material, and then the material picks up and the particle goes through the nozzle into the conveying pipe. The next thing, so you can see the suction nozzle, which is given at the left side, left bottom side. Next thing is the feeding intake unit. In case of feeding intake unit, there is an airlock gate which is made of different design and used in low pressure pipeline system for pressure up to 1.4 atmosphere. Okay, now rotary gate is such one type of airlock gate. The material is fed from the top funnel. The partitioned rotary drum takes the material and discharges at the bottom by gravity. The drum is closely fitted with casing which prevents air and pass from the outside to inside. Another type of airlock is the multiple door airlock, which operates on the principle of closing and opening of series of a flap door through stationary feeder. Okay, the next thing is the screw feeder, which is actually used for feeding materials into the pipeline working under medium pressure system. Now, these screw feeders are short length screw conveyor with screws having different differential piece decreasing the direction of the load discharge. This feature makes the load to pack the discharge end and prevents the high pressure air to escape through the feeding mouth of the feeder. You can see the figure and different parts of the screw feeder which is given in the figure. Next point is the blow tank or chamber feeders, which are basically used for charging powder materials into the pressure line. Such feeder consists of cylindrical vessel with conical bottom. The material is fed into the upper part of the chamber through a port, and after filling the vessel, it is shut off. Then the compressed air is introduced into the lower part, which moves the material, and on the top of the vessel, to the force the loosed in material to move through the feeding pipe into the main line of the pressure conveyor. The figure is given on the right hand side. Another part you need to know, that is the changeover or diverter valve, which is actually allows the conveyed material in the pressure system, which can be delivered to a specific point out of a multiple storage point. This valve consists of CI body, that means cast iron body, having one flanged inlet and more than one flanged outlet. Then there is the separator or receiver. In case of separator, you can find the cyclone separator. Basically, the separator are used for separation of the solid materials from the air which conveys it. There are different type of separators we can use. One is the gravity or inertial type of separator, another is the cyclone type of separator. In case of gravity or inertial type, the solid laden air is admitted into the large volume of chamber called gravity chamber, in which the high velocity air loses its velocity and the solid falls due to the gravity. In case of cyclone separator, it is basically a conical bottom container or hopper provided with a suitable discharge valve at the bottom. Now, in case of this type of cyclone separator, the air escapes to the top from the cyclone separator through a pipe placed centrally and projecting down up to the certain length of the hopper, and the material separates from the air stream and falls at the bottom. And the last part is the dust collector or filter, where the air escapes from the separator form of a storage silo after depositing the bulk of the conveyed material, which may still contain some amount of fines or dust. To prevent atmospheric pollution and pollution, such fines through the blower of a suction system, often dust collector, are provided at the output end of the separator or storage silo. Various type of dust collector are used for separating this dust. Okay, so according to the degree of cleanliness of air, filters are classified into coarse or fine filter. So all of these are very important part for this type of pneumatic conveying system. Now coming to the summary, so in case of a pneumatic conveyor, bulk goods can be moved in the means of air through pipelines, and there are different type of pneumatic conveyor available, that is pipeline conveyor, air slide, tube conveyor, in which the pipeline conveyors are low pressure system and the other two are the high pressure, medium and high pressure system. And in case of air slide, there is some kind of inclination available along with the gravity conveyor, which is 4% to 5%, and due to the gravity the materials move. And the bulk material transport, in case of bulk material transport, the tube conveyor can be used, and it is very environmental friendly. And in case of tube conveyor, it is very important that no material can be goes out of the tube conveyor. That's why it is very effective for conveying any type of fine powdered product. Thank you for watching this video. If you find any problem, you can write to me under this video in the comment section. Please like my video, share the video if you can, and please subscribe my channel for getting more video. You can subscribe my channel through this link. Thank you for watching.